Hi, this is Graham from Jenham's Astro. The idea of this video is to see what views we can get of double stars using this telescope, the Skywatcher Skymax 127. Now, all we're going to do is going to take the basic scope and attach a digital SLR. So you might recall that the visual back on this scope has a thread on it for attaching to a T-ring. So I've got a T-ring here for my Canon camera, and I'm simply going to attach the camera like so onto the back of the scope. So it gives a nice secure attachment. Next, I'm going to put this onto an equatorial mount, and we're going to tour around some of the more popular double stars that are high in the sky here in the UK during the summer. Okay, so let's just focus a little bit on Vega to start with. Got the camera on the back of the scope, using the live view. Looks about right. Okay, so let's go for Albireo in Cygnus. So this is a 2 second frame taken with the camera speed at ISO 1600, and I think it nicely captures what's probably the most famous double star, certainly one of the most popular double stars in the Northern Hemisphere. If I zoom in a little bit, you can see that we've got a nice view of the amber primary magnitude 3 and the blue magnitude 5 secondary. They're 35 arc seconds apart and an easy split for the Maksutov. Okay, so let's go from Albireo to 61 Cygni. So this is 61 Cygni, it's 2 seconds again, this time at ISO 3200, and you can see the two dwarf stars, similar magnitudes, I think they're magnitude 5 and 6, and if we zoom in a little bit, I'd say they appear, to my eye at least, they appear to be orange. Next we're going to go from 61 Cygni to Epsilon Lyrae, double. Epsilon Lyrae, the double. So if we take a closer look at this frame, what I've had to do here is take a whole series of exposures with getting shorter exposures and slower exposure speed in order to try and capture the fact that each of these is actually a double. So I think you just about see there that we've resolved each of the pairs. They're about 2 arc seconds apart, and this is now a third of a second at ISO 100. So the stars to me look pretty well white, maybe a little bit yellow, and there it is, nice split of the famous double. And now let's go off to the hunting dogs to have a look at Cor Caroli. So this is Cor Caroli, as I call it, maybe Cor Caroli to some. This is 1 second exposure with speed of ISO 200. Now, it's quite low down in the sky for me, this one, and I think if we zoom in, we start to see a bit of false colour on these two stars. So we've got a magnitude 2.9 and magnitude 5.6, about 19 or 20 arc seconds apart. And I think in theory they're blue, white, and yellow, but to me, obviously, there's a bit of a mixture of the spectrum recorded on this image. False colour for sure. Okay, and now let's head off to Delta Cephei. So Delta Cephei, this is a 1 second frame, ISO 800, and it's the famous Cepheid variable, the prototype for that type of star, and the two components are yellow and blue. And if we take a little bit of a closer look, I think that the Maksutov's recorded the colour quite well, but now this is these stars are much higher in the sky for me at the moment, so we're not getting the false colour that we saw on the previous target. And finally, let's go back to Ursae Major and Mizar. And then moving on to the Great Bear. Here is Mizar and its companion Alcor, and naked eye double, test of visual acuity for many, many years. This is a 1 second frame ISO 400, and if I zoom in a little bit onto Mizar, we can see its companion star. In fact, it's a multiple star system, but this is the brightest component that we can see next to Mizar. So I'm quite happy with the results we've managed to get. Even though we've been limited in terms of magnification to the view we get with the digital SLR, I think you can see that if you hook up an eyepiece, and maybe if you use Barlow lenses, you're going to get an even better view of a lot of these double stars. Maksutov is clearly suited to that kind of object, and certainly not just for looking at planets. So I hope it's been useful. Get out there and look at those double multiple stars. Don't neglect those objects. Some lovely colours, and it's been full moon for the observations I've taken in this video, so it's one of those targets that you can still get good views on and get good astronomy done even when the sky is relatively light because of the moon. So hope it's been useful. Thanks for watching.